Hi, Jason. o'clock comes, I'm out.
Thank you.
that. Start out facing the same way. Well, I'd start out facing you. So if I was standing on that yellow block, I'd end up going back that way. The same way the yellow block was facing, going that way.
So you don't pop out. Sweep this. You don't tap.
Circle motion. You make a circle going around it. There you go. His foot going with you. This hand is pushing him away.
But it's here.
Right, left.
This way? Is your foot flat? Flat.
The majority of the weight is on the forward foot because the knee is coming next.
And you come here.
So it's still trying to get it.
But is your foot flat here? Like how this one?
The first motion is reverse. That foot is in front. Up. strike to get to the target. When you strike, that means if he doesn't block, he got hit. Hit him upside of his head. Then he will block once he got hit. He stepped in the female stands, wound up. Step.
Thank you.
block. I block one, but not both. When I move your block, I'm striking. Left hook. Punch. Block. Punch. Try. Oh, you touch with this hand, you're kicking. So watch my stance. What's my stance? What's my feet and knees doing? What's that stance right there? Cat. Punch that kick. I didn't leave my foot down, try it again. Bang! Right there, that was nice. You made him block. If he didn't block, he'd be eating a knuckle sandwich. Now you move his block. Bang! That's the knockout. You see it? Foot and hand. Now you take a step and strike with this hand. There you go, your body weight was behind the last strike because you took a step. Cat, no weight on the forward leg. Hand in, step. Your body weight was behind.
Too far away.
You're fine, and take your step.
Do I take my step with your left foot?
Punch it. I start on this side of your body. I struck to the center of your body. You block. I step to that side of your body. That means I step far enough. Right through. Like you're not there. That's what's important. Okay. Cat. Hand empty. Bang. I block this one. Could I block your foot?
No.
No. Because you got my mind up in the air right now. Take a step down and strike. Bang.
Here. I'm trying to figure out why I can't go too low on my stance. What if I go back?
Block. That's better.
Okay, stay. Go back.
Touch the floor. Touch the floor. Now, as your body's falling.
Letting gravity just do its job?
So your weight is going this way. I'm breaking that way.
Throw
his body, pump that arm.
blocking him. You're just.
I'm striking.
Tugging. Okay.
Make it in block. If you don't block it, you hit him side of his head. When I punch, you get a technique. Now you don't go in front of his face, hit him in the face. That makes him block. I punch. That's better. If he chamber his punch, you get hit him upside of his head. He better not chamber his punch like karate, because that hand right there go through concrete. So he blocked. What goes up must do what? So watch. Came down. Look at my stance.
Female.
Now. Female horse to the male horse. No. Foot. That foot came second. The other foot came first. One. Now, when that foot comes second, I'm in a female. And I threw an elbow. Watch, punch. That hand went out. Female. You see my elbow?
So you're like lame.
Yeah, I struck. I dropped. I'm on the wrong foot. Struck. Female. I threw an elbow. I'm winding up. Here. Wind up. Just like that. Try again.
So the first one's like this.
No, that was the punch.
So this one's like this. Then
try again. First one you wind up. Second one you step and then wind up. In your way, so you pull it down. You see his head now? Nope. Try it again. Bang! That's the knockout right there. He's already knocked silly when you hit him like that. Look how close you are. You want to get close. Putting him on his back. Wrong foot. That's the foot. Female horse to the male.
How come you felt like you were at full extension
on your last part? But you were doing okay, that was good. I felt it in my back. It's like if I go further, I'm gonna be aching.
here, hand here.
Right there.
That.
Yeah. Now, keep guiding your back. But you gotta stay in your horse.
That shit hurt, man.
You gotta stay in your horse.
Because otherwise,
because you're breaking that arm. But if you jump up out of your horse, you're not going to break the arm.
So when I felt your wrist go play, you wanted the whole arm to break.
Touch your ground. You follow, but I don't want to hurt you. Although it's control. See how controlled I am? Here's the break. So I stayed in my horse. That's the break.
Give me attention so I can figure it out.
Right there, keep him right there. That's the break on that arm. So once I'm on the floor, I'm going to the floor. Catch my arm with both of your arms. Both hands. Now it's getting broke right across your thigh. That horse stance is breaking his arm. Struck on him.
Elbow.
Point. Right hand or the left hand?
Right.
So your last strike is with your left. You're trying to put more power in that left hand.
Use your whole body.
Yeah. You're trying to put that chi in the left. So you get used to throwing it. It becomes like, it'll start feeling like the right hand. Stances and those, that movement is fours, female, horse stance.
So this leg is supposed to be having contact with that leg. This leg always has contact with that person.
Yeah, is you that close?
So you're here.
Or I'm right at the side of his leg, and then I'm behind him when I come with the other foot.
Right here, fours, like that. Here.
Females.
Here.
That leg went behind my leg, that your opponent's leg, when you step to that position. It's like throw, push. Throw, push. The push is inside.
So here.
The push is inside. That's leverage. My movement does this. Four. Female. Throw. Push.
Throw him over and bring him back.
You threw him over and then you break his arm.
all it's done as soon as you hit your horse stand. So it's like forwards, female, throw, push.
Well, and that's when your arm is like locked in the hip and you shift back.
Oh, push.
And this is rips out.
Elbow. Broke his elbow. Throw. Push. Right there, that's the technique.
One.
got his wrist right there. Push both of his, push both of your hands down against him. That's the leverage, like he's working a pump. Not step and then catch down. It's like catch down. As soon as my fist came to this position, it's the Chinese bar. Right there, you set yourself up to kick it. There you go. Don't break it up. So it's hands and feet at the same time. But not like hand and then foot. I'm breaking it up when I do that. Try to send your power to your left hand. Concentrate on your last right. It was power. Throw with your horse stance.
Don't
make it two, make it one. I go one, that means he's already falling to the floor.
So you don't even want me to be more dramatic with it. So stop. Here.
One. That's where he's low right there. He's already falling because your hands took him to the low. Then I come back and push.
So how do you make it one? You just
one.
One.
As soon as I hit the horse stance, my hands are taking his body weight. His body is where my hand is, at the full extension. So I don't have to bend to push in there, just one. Full extension.
Just break. One. And then the last thing you have is his arm.
I have his arm in this hand. And it's across the thigh. I push it. There you go. I pushed it when I got to that position.
This hurts me to do.
I can do it. You broke it up that time, make it one, not two.
What's the difference?
One. That was better. Don't stop.
So go in quick and come out quick.
Before you did it this way.
Oh, because I'm going with this.
Yep.
Take that's too long. Get the time to defend. First step, thanks for taking my hand. Is that right?
This was the pull, but that was the push.
I hear you. The
first time you went to the
house, drop it down on the side. I'm gonna take it back in my hand. I'm gonna take it from
us. Well, he's here. That's why your first one you went here. So the next one.
Drop down on the side.
So 1, 2.
So you don't make him, he can't touch your head. So you went that way. Now it becomes the throw. This hand comes out as
a hook.
Here's your pull. Here. Pull to you. Pull. There you go. Now, this will pull to you. This, in other words, the push away. That's the throw. Pull his hand down in front of your face.
That'll change the dynamic of that.
No, you walked in with your elbow. Walk right in with an elbow. Don't have to lift the elbow. You left your head from it. Watch, punch me. If I come this way now, I drop my hand. Can you touch my head?
Yeah.
That means I got hit. So watch. Up underneath your hand. My hand is high enough to keep your hand away from my head. I walked in with the elbow. So my weight is behind my elbow. That's where the power is. My weight behind my elbow. Now I tried to strengthen up my elbow.
You just slid
in. I just walked in. That's the knockout. Pull to you and push away.
So right here, I don't really have to move until he makes that next move.
Try to move. This way to try to hit the eye. Here I kept his hand in the air, and I walked in with my elbow. I'm on this side of his body. I'm going to the center of his body. Oh. Now I'm going to that side of his body.
How you go from here? Is that the blood? It looks like I'm from the blood.
Right.
Oh.
Watch the right foot. Right foot.
Shit.
Now here come the left foot. I'm at the center of his body. Now I'm going to this side of it. Up this side of
this
body.
Is a cat? Not a cat? What would be the knee though?
That sets up the next one. So this side of his body to the center. Cat. Step back.
Oh.
I'm like back, forward. Wrong foot. You can move slow without hurting this man. Just in case you might make a connect by accident, you take you move with control. Step back, move forward. Other side of his body to get away from that hand.
But now that he told her, I have to
watch your knee. Control. Take his head then. It don't take a lot of power to hurt this man with your knee. So it's control. First, I want to get his head there. Then I let him know I'm raising my knee at the same time. If you just put it there, then you can get. That's how accidents happen. That's a little bone right there. Leg, that's a big bone. So I want to hit him with a big bone. Right there. And you're doing these type of kicks. Dead weight. That's a dangerous kick. The reason why, because you can break bone doing it. In that dangerous kick. Step, female, dangerous kick.
You can elbow me. Yes, I'm going to fall here.
Because if you drop your elbow,
if I drop it, you're heavier. So you just got to fall.
You're going to control your head.
You got to keep your hand between his hand and your head.
That's the center. I get out from up underneath it when I go to the cat.
Yeah. Oh, so I'm already in the cat. I just felt
it. There you go, that was good.
Okay.
That's leverage. That's the beginning of your high key, it's a throw. Wrong foot. this side of his body, you came to the center. You went to this side of his body. But then when I, after I knee, I'm stepping back through his body. I'm going that way.
Oh, he's not throwing it this way, he's throwing it that way.
Yeah. Okay. But when he was over here, that's where he was going.
Oh, okay. Alright. I thought he was still going like
that.
Second movement. You don't
drop your hand. Don't drop your hand. You get smacked up by the head.
You did this.
So I was supposed to say I'm the same line as your chin.
This hand is up here.
Yeah, try to get as.
Because you want to get you closer to the step. Not that I have to drop my hand to the rest of my belly.
He's trying to find his strength.
Now I see how little it looks like it really does. It's like,
right. You're trying to go, pow! And it raises up.
You want to use Superman power, but you're using too much energy, too much strength. All you got to do is walk in. That's enough strength. Don't pull your hand down by your head. You kept it above your head.
Once he does this, he's got to fly.
Step back.
It's like he's stepping back. He's got a block. Oh, there you go.
Now you're at his center. Now you go to the other side of his body. That brought you up from up underneath his hand. Raise your knee then. Pull his head to you and step through.
Push his head down. My knee comes this way and go this way.
The hand is going that way.
Show me it real quick because I'm trying to figure out. I go here, here, or here.
Oh, you twist him off of
hey. Oh. Yeah.
Send his head one way, his hands the other way. Back the way you start.
All up.
Knee. Like that?
See where you left his hand on top by your head? I just want to send it further that way.
But if you
send it further that way, putting stress on him, so you can be easy.
So just let go or as soon as I feel like you're trying.
Yeah, I got the whole thing.
You too? What the dimension is this?
What? You dropped your hand.
Every time
you drop your hand, every time I feel you do like this, you've done it.
Drop the head. If that goes through concrete where you got hold of both your head.
Because you made me block. Now you drop your hand, I'm gonna drop my hand right with you.
That's where he go through concrete. That'd be bust your skull.
Careful.
Just walk. There you go. Left foot. Just walk.
See, then you're gonna follow me anyway.
Almost. Ooh. There you go, keep going.
Said let go. Let go
when
here.
When it's going up, it's dangerous. When it's coming down,
he said let go right there.
Yeah,
I was supposed to let go of you. Because he said hold it until I put his head go that way.
That's dangerous. That's
almost at the same time.
If you going that way,
that'll break an arm. That'll break a leg.
Here to here, you're going this way. So you're here.
So I'm going this way and I'm shifting this.
Yeah, I just keep going. Like I'm running towards that wall. Once I got that here, I'm going to keep on going.
Fall through.
You knocked out. Why should I go, man, your head is here. Throw your head and twist your arm and keep going that way.
See how he's going that way? You've been through.
Don't turn back around this way.
If you try to lock up,
don't go here and turn back around this way because now you can't throw his hand that way.
Yep, your momentum is coming toward me instead of taking going through.
So going this way. So once you get to here, I'm going to keep going this way. He's twisting his head.
I see
his body. Keep going that way.
So he just thank y'all a moment.
Next man.
Ball up.
that.
Head's going that way.
Here, brush, here.
Oh. The body's still, your weight is coming toward me. You want your weight to come toward that wall.
So you come to here, don't you put the foot down.
I'm going this way. That way. Instead, I was going this way.
Yes, you're trying to
turn it back the other way. That's another thing.
That's the throw. The Tai Chi to their energy ball.
Drop your elbow.
See when your elbow is by your shoulder.
You keep doing it. Because I can, when you do this, block. No, block. When you do this, I feel this. I feel your hand.
Like
I feel your hand come away. So you can do up like this. As soon as I feel your hand come away,
and the female system dictates, if your hand is coming down, he ain't going to pull it back up. He's going to go with it. He ain't going to go against it. That means it's going down, he's going to drop right on it.
That's why you keep getting caught up in this position right here, like, hey, man, what you doing? Yeah, because you keep doing it to yourself. I'm not doing it to you.
Yeah.
There you go.
Down, I raise my knee. Now when I step, yes, it's broke back.
Yeah, that's it.
When everything's the right way, you feel the pull that you're supposed to.
Yeah. He gonna feel it from his arm, from his wrist, all the way down to over here on this side of his body. His body is going like this. Well, he's knocked out, so he might not feel nothing. Nope, not that.
Stop throwing.
Remember what Francis said. When you do your last motion and you're throwing, he's knocked out. When you throw him, he's knocked out.
He's already knocked out. He don't feel a thing.
That's why he's going to be thrown.
He don't feel nothing. He don't feel no pain. He's knocked out.
He ain't going to be locked. He ain't going to lock in like you're feeling him right there. Mm-hmm. You knocked him out. Nope. Oh. Try it again. You're putting too much in the movement. Think it too hard.
Relax. Thinking about it.
Don't worry about his move. Do your technique. You got a technique. Do it like Tai Chi, like it's right out of one of your forms.
Are you ending in a cat?
I'm going this way.
Well, so this far, I was like this. So,
here. You already came to check to here. You didn't catch that. Was just a touch.
Thank you too hard.
You just did it. 1, 2, 3, 4. You just did it. You counted it out. 1, 2, 3. You should be up and lifting all the 3.
That's the knockout.
So I got to feel the pull before I even need it.
Yes. It's going to be together.
Here. Knee.
Well, the knee and this. This is the one where your equilibrium goes. This is
right. So true.
This is going to take your equilibrium right into the poof.
What was that?
If not, you might have to put your hand up.
Nope. Then I slip. Step right through.
I like you broke my neck right there.
Then I slip. So he wasn't even there.
If he put his hand up to block this strike, that's good. He's going to put this hand up, that hand up to block this strike. Yeah, that's good. Okay, now you got all your hands in the way. Crack! Step that foot down, I'm stepping it down and going up that way.
Throw your head, tap, then step this way.
Tap. Everything is going in that direction. You're already knocked out. Because if you don't block, I'm going to stick you in your eye. First of all, I'm going to stick you in your eye.
And all it takes is a touch. Make him stop doing battle, just a touch. Didn't have to send off all this power like, I'm on. I didn't need it. All it was, this is your Superman power. Touch. That's the real Superman power. All of this ain't when you're practicing with your friends and they out like that, you ain't using no power. You ask me. Here's your power. Touch. That'll make him stop doing battle. Ball up, then stretch out.
By the time you put that hand up to block it, that elbow should be sitting right here by his face.
And you walk to him. You didn't use your power like, in. All you had to do is walk to him. Your weight was gravity. Is where the power is at.
Take the dip out.
Take like I'm going under and I'm going.
Yep, through. See, you're trying to reach for his head. He's too tall for that. So all you have to do is walk in with your elbow. If I'm this short, when I walk in, that's what I strike right there. I don't try to reach up to his face. So if you're small, if you touch his body, anywhere you hit with that elbow, he'll feel it. You just protect your head when you're walking in.
You can be 6'6". You gonna reach up and hit a 6'6" dude in there?
Yeah, that's extra movement.
Right. Just strike you in the throat.
His chest is there. I walk right into his chest. Bang.
That should be up and down. That should be up and down. And there you go.
Same time.
That should be up and down.
It shouldn't be
up. It's only up and down. Nope. It ain't no pull. It ain't no weight. That's one move.
It's one quick. That's
once this hand touches.
That was like Tai Chi right there. That was smooth.
One, you got it. One, two, three.
So don't have many.
But
it's easier to have my knee.
Yeah, you can have it up because I ain't gonna sit here and let you keep me in my face.
Going to his other shoulder. You're on one shoulder, you go to his other shoulder.
I was on his shoulder.
Yeah. Who's shoulder that? Yeah. The same.
One shoulder, other shoulder.
Make sure that you step through.
One second left to take.
See when you step, you see which shoulder you went to?
Nah.
Which one?
My
so you never traveled at all. You're traveling through the man. You're not traveling when you move with the wrong foot.
Right.
Whatever right here. Got your size, hit you in the face. Taller than you.
Chin,
chest, here, sternum. Hit you right here, man. You stop breathing. That's sternum right there. Man. You don't want to put it in that sternum. Come out of the lung. That's it.
And if you don't block, you take whatever you take.
First thing you're gonna do is try to grab it. You do it. One, two,
three,
four. There you go. That feels, that flow felt a little bit better. Now you just got this up. Now you got the flow into it.
I've been grabbing, you've been twisting this arm so many times. I feel like as soon as I go like this, I do still want to go in.
Yeah. So walking in, you want to drive.
So y'all, like, you ain't got to do that. Just be simple with that falling.
Let's keep it from happening.
So it's a block one.
That's dangerous.
Yeah. So for me, it is for y'all to get struck. But since I'm smaller,
so
I'm just
dangerous.
Like,
I feel this.
Can I touch?
Is this? Ain't hit anything right up in here?
That's how
that's a strike.
That's all right. It works with being your eye. I don't want to make a mistake and hit your eye. So I started trying to go to safety now.
Strike.
I knew where I wanted to go, but now I want to move with speed.
Right.
So you are right. It is a hammer. That does seem like a hammer.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, once you do this,
fast.
More music
left.
Better music than
that. Right.
You gotta find a new speed.
Right, center, left, right. you start over here, look at this prayer, you start over here, you go back this way, you should be back over here. So wherever that first right quick steps to, you should be, you will be on the same line. But
there you go. I use my fist on the bottom. All
right. Left.
Oh!
There we go. Now I feel it when you're walking back. You can't use this out there. Block. Sir, when he did his break, he cat stands and stepping, strike. Cat. I'm trying to see where the feet are. Oh, left foot. Left foot to step forward.
Trying to find his feet. For his eye because you can hurt him. So watch again where I put my hand. Stretch out. this position, but he was buff. He didn't want to go that way. So this is where he's tense at. I snapped him around that shoulder. That popped that popped his shoulder by dropping him to a stand. Like, snap. Like a chicken wing. It won't take much, just a little bit there. A little pull against them tendons and ligaments right there, you know, a shot. Maybe with the right left, right.
Okay. We blocked. All right, yeah.
Pushing your hand down so you can go with it. Now, you want this hand to go straight to towards your knee. There you go, that's the break right there. In his back, I'll put that knee against his back.
So each time you go in more, if you get the position.
But what I mean, you took it. He went in a circle, and you went in a circle.
Have to go in.
straight your arm is almost bent. Control that with his head. Stretch out your neck.
Did you knee before? Did you do something? You were stepping on this right here. But when you did that part, you did. You knee here and you step down here?
Knee is the baller, foot is the stretch out.
So your knee and kick the tendon. Into the tendon. How do I make sure?
This is...
here, here, right over the top.
So it's really this just tight.
Head was back that way, you'd be way off balance. See where my head is at? Your object is a bit behind my head. So punch. I'm in front of your head. Up, you're going to end up hurting yourself. So
I wasn't. It just happened. So.
Now, I took this step, but then your hand is right there in front of you, right? So I'm stepping through. Now, when you reach for my hand, I'm blocking. From my head, but that ain't. Taking that step toward the mirror. That's what I was stepping for. That was good. Look where I'm at now. Instead of you not taking a step, then you got to wrestle with the thing. Your body weight was going that way, and my hand had to go with your body weight. Body weight. There you go. That's the motion. Look where it's at. Your first motion that you did today. Thank you. First motion.
their heads. I barely see this. I was focused on this for so long.
In there somewhere.
Yeah. Where do you need?
Just gotta calm down your mind.
I remember that's how three strikes. I can't say that anywhere. I think it was
a hit.
Looked like a flurry.
Was that it?
Second.
It was in there somewhere.
Entertainment.
hold right there. Your power comes because you wound up. You didn't wind up enough. That's my position. Wind up. Force. Stretched out, wound up. Still having trouble winding up.
So I was trying to figure out what angle I can hold myself at. I can't hold it.
That's three instead of two. I'm using this strength up here, but my power comes from weight, my weight went there. Stretched out, my weight went there. You're still doing arm punches. There you go.
It doesn't behave yet.
Wind up.
Throw your right hip back. Throw your right hip back.
Oh, that's where you're supposed to be, right there.
Throw this right hip. Okay.
I don't feel it. Stop.
Where you go right here?
Yeah, but I gotta be able to catch myself, hold myself.
Yeah, you're holding yourself. Do it again, Cranston. Watch his body.
Good.
See where he's facing?
Now, my right hip. I'm all the way over there.
He's going back that way. That means he almost turned a circle. He wound up so much, it's like he's turning a circle. When his foot come out, he went through the full circle.
So you went to fours. So now I can take my horse stance and walk.
So he's cut to a horse right there. That's a walk. That means he made a circle.
You're going into your horse. You ended up right here.
Yeah, you didn't go all the way.
It ends up here into your horse. It's like your horse being over here. Okay.
So I'm not torturing.
Turn your right hip.
See how your chest is facing the mirror? You didn't turn your body. No power's in there.
Turn your right hip. Nope, don't throw your elbow. Turn your right hip.
You want to turn your body till it's almost going back that way. Yeah. Then when your horse stance comes, you're going that way.
I know it's not a killing, but you gotta bring this.
You gotta bring up that foot to turn myself to almost be going back this way.
With the elbow, he would have knocked you out right there. Didn't have to use all that his arm strength as a body weight. Bow! And a dead weight. Dead weight club right upside your head.
This is a strike.
Oh! You can't stand up under that power right there.
Could you go over the top right? One move. Open up.
Wrong step.
I know. I'm trying to figure out where I can throw myself.
It's like doing that elbow. I walk in with that elbow, don't throw it up. I'm not throwing my elbow. I'm throwing my body.
Body weight. The elbow just followed that body weight. Wrong steps. Chest is facing me. You want it to go toward that wall.
I don't want it. My body doesn't want it. It can't. I mean, it can, but it hurts.
You gotta practice. It takes time. These techniques, like I say, I'm telling the young ones in class, these techniques, sometimes it take a lifetime to get these techniques. Lifetime. Just because you're techniques. So up to date, you don't think you have it. You haven't perfected it.
Can you see me? Can your chest see me?
So just because you saw the technique, you were able to play with it.
Can your chest see me?
It take a lifetime to perfect.
I should be already going that way when I drop into my feet. I'm already going this way. I'm just stepping. I'm still kidding.
So since it takes a lifetime to trip it back, you're always telling that. But they say, well, you know Kung Fu, but now I play Kung Fu. I don't know it.
If you were good.
To know it means you know a lot. We'll get all that information. See?